In this video, we will examine the factors that cause aggregate demand to increase and shift right or decrease and shift left. Aggregate demand will shift rightwards towards AD2 when increasing and leftwards towards AD1 when decreasing. I've drawn the curves red and green to correspond to the following information on aggregate demand curve shifts. Next, we will examine the factors that would cause consumption to rise and fall. These will be the factors that influence consumer spending throughout an economy. We will look at the factors that cause consumption to increase first. When consumers have positive expectations and high confidence about the future, they are more likely to spend in the present. The understanding behind this is that they have a positive outlook on the future. They may believe their job is secure, opportunity is available, and businesses are performing well. Their friends may be finding work relatively easily, and many indicators point to continued prosperity. On the other hand, if their outlook is bleak and they feel that the economy is experiencing a downturn, their confidence levels drop and expectations become more pessimistic. They are more careful with spending and are more inclined to save or pay off debt. To understand why, you should put yourself in the shoes of someone who has just seen their colleagues get laid off. If this person returns home and turns on the news to hear news of doom and gloom in the economy, their confidence is likely to drop and they will take careful measures to protect themselves in the case that the downturn hits them next. If the value of an asset, such as a home, starts to rise in value, people may feel wealthier and start to increase their spending. If other assets, such as the value of stocks and bonds and one's investments, rise in value, then this could also lead to greater spending. Conversely, if the stock market crashes or house prices plummet like we saw in the 2008-2009 recession, then people are less likely to spend and more likely to save in fear of what may come next for their job or household. If the government reduces income or sales taxes, it will either result in people having greater disposable income or paying lower prices for goods and services. As a result, aggregate demand will increase. To counter that, an increase in personal income tax or sales taxes will reduce disposable income or increase the sale price of goods and services. Prior to the 2008 crisis, there was a rapid growth of credit available, which led to many people getting mortgages that could not afford them. By securing home loans quite easily, consumers were quick to purchase homes at a rapid rate. This drove up home prices and eventually led to the inevitable crash. Soon after the recession hit, credit became much harder to secure. Borrowing to buy a home is now much stricter in comparison to pre-crisis. As a result, consumption is reduced and aggregate demand falls. If interest rates are higher, it is also generally more expensive to borrow and more rewarding to save. As a result, consumption will fall. If interest rates are lower, it is cheaper to borrow and less rewarding to save, and therefore consumption will rise. Next, we'll examine the factors that influence business spending throughout an economy. Remember, we're looking at the overall spending throughout the entire economy and not just focusing on a specific sector. Similar to consumption, a reduction of the interest rate will result in cheaper borrowing and a greater likelihood to pursue investment projects. Conversely, increasing the interest rate will result in less borrowing and a reduced likelihood of pursuing investment projects. If business confidence is high and firms have a positive outlook about the economic future, then they are more likely to invest. They will ramp up production in anticipation. On the other side of this, if firms have a negative outlook about the future, they will likely reduce investment. This could involve reducing production and cutting the workforce. Thirdly, if the government enacts corporate tax cuts, businesses face lower production costs and are able to retain greater profit. They are then more likely to increase production and raise output. If the government decides to raise corporation tax, they are increasing the cost of doing business. This will likely result in a reduction of output and a fall in production. Thirdly, we'll examine government spending. Generally, government spending is influenced by the overall performance of the economy, but there are other times when they may choose to spend. Let's see what they are. Government spending falls under fiscal policy. When the government is pursuing expansionary fiscal policy, they will increase spending and reduce taxes. Specifically, for government spending as a component of aggregate demand, we focus on expenditure. There are many areas of government expenditure, including government services, war, and infrastructure projects. We'll explore the categories of government spending further in the video on fiscal policy. For now, what you should understand is that an increase in government spending will result in an increase in aggregate demand. Part of our future analysis will consider the impact of government spending on economic growth. Finally, net exports. We have to see the factors that would increase or decrease the value of net exports. These factors can impact either the amount a country buys from or sells to the rest of the world. Net exports are calculated by subtracting imports from exports. For net exports to increase, there would need to be an increase in exports or a fall in imports, ceteris paribus. If the domestic currency depreciates, then it takes less foreign currency to purchase our domestic currency. Here's an example to clarify using China as the domestic country. If the Chinese RMB depreciates against the dollar, that means it now takes more RMB to buy US dollars, making American imports more expensive. That also means that the US dollar now buys more RMB. This means it takes less dollars to buy Chinese exports, which will lead to an increase in exports for China, increasing the Chinese aggregate demand. The opposite also holds true. When the domestic currency appreciates, it takes more foreign currency to purchase our domestic currency. Therefore, for similar reasons as mentioned just before, our exports will fall and our imports of foreign goods will rise. Secondly, when incomes abroad increase, the market for our exports grows larger. If the rest of the world gets richer, they are more likely to buy a country's exports. This can be seen in the rising Chinese demand for luxury goods from around the world. The Chinese purchases of Italian cars will increase the aggregate demand for Italy. However, when incomes abroad are falling, aggregate demand can fall. Chinese exports fell during 2008 to 2009 in large part due to the global recession. This reduced the value of net exports and thus real GDP fell for the Chinese economy. Also, by increasing the competitiveness of their goods and services, a country can increase their net exports, whether through price or quality. By making goods more attractive in the global market, they are more likely to be exported. That's an extensive look at the factors that cause aggregate demand to shift, and it's important that you get some practice in doing so. Some students consider the aggregate demand curve easier to come to grips with than aggregate supply, which we will be examining in a later video. As for now, get as much practice as you can with aggregate demand shifts. If you have any questions or comments, please leave a message below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. You can also tweet me at enhancedtuition. Include a link in the video notes for the slideshare presentation. And I'll see you in the next one.